Good afternoon, everyone. Hello, welcome to Central Christian Church. And I am so happy to see everyone, and also happy Father's Day to all the fathers. Yeah, and let's prepare our heart for the sermon later.
欢迎大家来到中央基督教会，然后我非常开心的去见到大家，然后祝大家父亲节快乐。让我们用我们的心去聆听，然后去领受等一下的这个sermon。大家下午好，让我们预备我们的心来祷告。祷告之前，我们为大家读一段经文，诗篇86章。 第9到第10节，主啊，你所造的万民都要来敬拜你，他们也要荣耀你的名，因你的因你为大，且行奇妙的事，唯独你是神。让我们低头祷告。我们在天上的父神，感谢你今天带领着我们能够聚在这里，感谢你时常带着慈爱的陪伴。 不断的用着你的话语关爱和警惕我们，帮助我们远离罪恶。父神啊，我们都知道这世界充满了罪的诱惑，使我们缺乏安全感。我们知道说唯有神你充满智慧的话语，能够帮助我们拉近彼此的关系，远离不好的恶习，并且以神你和好。 我们现在呢，生活在这里的我们的疫情仍然存在，求父神你保守着我们的生活呢，能够平安健康，那些有病痛的弟兄姐妹呢，能够可以得到有效的医治。感谢神带领着今天的机会，并且保守接下来的传道能够带给我们信息，并且让我们能够谦虚的去。 学习，能够在每一天学以致用，感谢神聆听这个祷告，奉耶稣的名祈求，阿门。Amen,
brothers, sisters, and friends. Let's all rise and sing some songs. 弟兄姐妹朋友们，让我们站起来。
God sent His Son, they call Him Jesus, they call Him to love, heal and forgive. He lived and died to buy my pardon, and empty grave is dead to prove my Savior lives. Because He lives, I can face tomorrow. Because He lives, all fear is gone. Because I know He holds the future, and the life is worth the living just because He lives. How sweet to hold a newborn baby and feel the pride in joy He gives. We are greater still calm assurance. This child can face uncertain day just because he lives. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know he holds the future, and life is worth the living just because he lives. And then one day I'll cross the river, I find life's fine, no worry pain. And then has death its way to victory, I'll see the light of glory, then I'll know he lives. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know he holds the future, and life is worth the living just because he lived. Because he lived, because he lived, I can face tomorrow. Because he lived, all fear is gone. Because I know he holds the future, yeah. Because he lives, and life is worth the living just because he lives. Amen.我的救赎者活着，他是用火的主，当我在深谷迷失时，他领我走正义的路。我知道我的救赎者活着，他是用火的主。 当我在旷野谷底时，他伴我做我的灯。我知道我的救赎者永远活着，我心不再忧虑，我要在每一个日夜中
领受他的丰盛之海，我知道我的救赎者永远活着，我灵不再沉睡。当号角响起的那一夜，我将见他荣光之面。 我知道我的救赎者活着，他只用我的主。当我在旷野，当我在旷野孤独时，他伴我做我的灯。我知道我的救赎者永远活着。 我心不再忧虑，我要在每一个日夜中领受他的丰盛之爱。
我知道我的救赎者永远活着，我灵不再沉睡，我灵不再沉睡。那一天我将见他荣光之面，我知道，我知道我的救赎者永远活着，我心不再犹豫，我心不再忧虑。 No， 日夜中领受他的丰盛之爱，我知道我的救赎者永远活着，我灵不再沉睡，我灵不再沉睡。那一天我将见他荣光之面，当号角响起的那一天，我将见他荣光之面。Amen. Please all be seated. 大家请坐。
家里有个人很苦，三头六臂，刀枪不入，他的手掌有一点粗，牵着我学会了走路。谢谢你光顾我的小怪物，你是我写过最美的情书，纽扣住一个家的幸福，爱着你呀风雨无阻。老爸老爸，我们去哪里呀？有你在我天不怕地不怕。
宝贝宝贝，我是你的大树，一生陪你看日出。
你是我心中最棒的英雄，拥有着我能依靠的肩膀，我拼命发芽，你白了头发，也还是最棒的英雄。 老爸老爸，我们去哪里呀？有你在我天不怕地不怕，宝贝宝贝，我是你的大树，一生陪你看日出。老爸老爸，我们去哪里呀？你就是我的天大和地大，啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦。
父亲节快乐！
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 Hello, 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 testing one. Hello, 没有
testing, testing, test, test one, two, test. Hello, 大家好
Hello,、oh, okay.、
All、testing.、
Right. Oh, 好大声 Okay, okay, that was so、beautiful, yeah?
哎、hey, ，那么的唱的那么的好，对不对？
Good job, young ladies.
年轻的少女们唱得太棒了，谢谢。
I like the part the dads are bulletproof.
我喜欢呢、啊，就是他们说父亲很像啊，可以抵挡所有子弹那样。
Amen. All right, thank you again. To all the fathers, Happy Father's Day.
给所有的父亲们啊、父亲节快乐。
Amen. So, okay, so let's continue on our Bible study, on our series on Come Follow Me, The Road to Spiritual Maturity.
让我们来继续的去学习，来跟随我，去建立这个属灵的这个生命。
So, the series that we're going through here gives us a guideline, okay? Some strategy,you know, the process that can help us to know how to grow to be spiritual mature before God.
在这里呢，我们可以学习到就是如何可以在神的面前去学习成熟成长。
So obviously, it, you know, it doesn't contain everything, but it contains a good core principle that can help us.
当然这不能够包含所有的，只不过它却把重点把那一个基础都讲了出来。
I love this model where we can look at spiritual maturity in terms of how we as human beings grow physically to maturity.
那么在这边我很喜欢他教导我们如何能够用、就是我们、成长的过程里面来去、跟、属灵生命去同样的做一个对比。
And we all know that we all need to grow up, right? To be mature as a person.
就是我们每个人都需要成长的。
Okay, and you will get, if you are a parent, or even your child, you get worried, you know? You're growing physically, but maturity-wise, you don't grow.
很多时候呢，我们、从、婴孩一直到做一个父母，我们都很害怕、在成长的过程里面，我们呢到底是不是真的是已经成熟了。
So, okay, so the stages here, simplify, all right? You have infant, then to child, to young adult, and to parents.
当然了，在这边呢，我们就简化了、这几种阶段，从婴孩、一直到、小孩到年、到最后做父母为止。
So you find spiritual infant, just like any infant, they need a lot of guidance.
就很像婴孩一样，属灵婴孩也是需要很多的引导。
Okay, and a young child, kindergarten, not primary year age, they tend to be what more self-focused about them own self.
那这一小孩，比如说小学的，那么他们都常常把就是自己很自我。
Okay, and even some young people, okay, some teens, we tend to, you know, because we want to know the world, we tend to be more focused on ourselves.
甚至呢，这年轻人呢，也是很多时候因为想要更加去探索这世界呢，变成我们呢，都会把重点重心都放在自己身上。
Okay, and then of course, as you grow into adult, you have more responsibility in life. Then you are more outward focused. So spiritual adult, young adult, you are more kingdom focused.
那么在成长年成年人呢，我们呢因为比较多的责任，比较多的比较成熟了，负起的责任比较多，所以呢在神的国度里面呢也会担起更加多的责任。
So obviously the goal is to be a spiritual parent, or Jesus says as a fisher of men, where you grow to a stage where you can teach, guide, nurture other people to maturity.
就好像耶稣基督他其实是想要要求和要每一个人能够成长，能够在属灵生命成长到一个地步，我们可以照顾，也能够去帮助引导其他人。
So for today, we're going to focus on spiritual infancy, the stage where we need guidance.
那今天呢，我们会把焦点放在很需要人去引导的那个属灵婴孩的那个阶段。
So before we even enter into this stage, we need to be what? Born again.
那当然还没有甚至进入这一个阶段之前呢，你必须要重生，重新来过才可以这样做。
So let's read the passage in John chapter 3, verse 3 to 5, where it talks about how we get born again.
所以让我们这里来读约翰福音第三章第三到第五节，第三节，耶稣回答，我实实在在的告诉你，人若不重生，就不能见神的国。尼哥底母说，人老了怎样重生呢？难道他能再进母腹生出来吗？耶稣回答，我实实在在告诉你，人若不是从水和圣灵生的，就不能进神的国。
So it's, you can see, all right, the parallel between Christianity and physical life.
我们这边呢很清楚看见，就是耶稣怎样引用人的就是一般的生命和属灵生命拿来做比较。
So here Jesus says, if you want to be in the kingdom of God, you must be born again.
耶稣呢这边说，他说，如果你要进入神的国，你一定要重生。
Do you remember how to be born again?
你还记得如何重生吗？
Okay, the Bible says, born again of water and the Spirit. And what is that?
那耶稣这边他提到说是从水和圣灵重生，那是怎么一回事？
That's when we have faith in Jesus, repent of our sins, and we get baptized for the forgiveness of sin and to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit.
那就是在当我们决定能够就是跟随耶稣悔改受洗，而且能够接受神的圣灵。
So don't ever forget your spiritual birthday.
所以呢，今天呢，不好忘记你重生的那一天。
Because that was the day where you enter into this special world.
因为呢，那天呢，是你进入这个很特别的这个世界，很特别的生命。
Okay, that was the day where all your sins were washed away. You are new. You can start afresh into the kingdom of God.
因为在那一天呢，你是从生命重新再一次来过。
All right, so now let's go and talk about spiritual infancy.
所以我们来看属灵婴孩的阶段。
So we group here not just babies, but even toddlers, the kindergarten age, okay? So we a little bit wider range.
我们这边呢就是把这一个包含了甚至是不单单是婴孩，甚至包括小孩等等这些。
So as parents, I'm sure you know the characteristic, right, of a little child.
如果当一名父母，你肯定知道这些婴孩这小孩是怎么样子的。
Okay, and of course if it's Friday we'll have a discussion, like D group about it, but you know Sunday I'll just show you a list.
所以呢，如果是在我们有小组的讨论会呢，可以谈的更多。但是现在呢，今天我给你们一个列表。
So, a kid, a child, all right. Here are some characteristics. It's not all, but some of them.
那当然了，这不是全部啦，就是它的特征。但是是一些重点。
They're very dependent, isn't it? Okay, little children are very dependent on their parents.
那小孩呢？他的特征是他依赖性很强，他很喜欢跟着父母。
Okay, and that is important because they need someone to protect them and to nurture and to guide them.
那很重要，那是因为他需要那一些父母去保护他们和培育他们。
You know, I'm always so amazed how God plan out everything, even physical life and then spiritual life. You know how God knows a child cannot be by itself; it needs the parents to take care of them.
当然了，很惊讶，就是神他的那个智慧，甚至说他已经知道了，就是说，孩子小孩呢，就需要父母如何很清楚的去很小心的去照顾他们。
And then kids, they're very active, right? Easygoing, you know. Leeching now is grown up a little bit.But still very active, right? Right now, non-stop, my goodness. Okay, he's still so active. And that's what little kids are like.
是的，小孩的特征是活泼， you know, 很好动，就很像李静这样子，对不对？他虽然他长大，但是他还是非常的好动，非常的活泼。
So, young people, okay, remember your parents. You were so active during those age. You wore your mom and dad out.
那些 在这边呢，年长的那些，你还记得你们当初小的时候，你如何让你的父母多么的疲倦吗？
I can still remember chasing my children all around the house. Oh my goodness.
或者是那些当父母的那些，甚至是我还记得我这样子追我的小孩，累到要死。
It was fun for a little while.
有趣一短暂。
Okay, first 5 minutes, yeah, it was so fun. But after that, please stop. Okay.
一开始是很好玩啦，可是之后呢，就累得不得了。
And then they little children, right? Ignorant, they lack knowledge because their mind is totally empty.
那这些小孩呢，他的另外一个特征是他缺乏知识，他们还不知道很多东西。
And it can be so cute, isn't it?
不知也不知的可爱。
I even remember my own daughter, you know, my eldest daughter Erica. Okay, at this particular age, how the cuteness of her ignorance.
那我还记得我的女儿 Erica, 她在小的时候，她那个缺乏就是缺乏知识，但是却又很可爱的那个。
So one day we had a Bible talk with all the friends come, and you know Bible talk, right? At the home we have lots of food, and mom was in the kitchen cooking noodles.
那我还记得有一次，就是很多朋友来参加我们那个圣经讨论会，然后呢，母亲在厨房忙碌的在准备食物了。
Okay, next time we're gonna start this also have Bible talks at home where we have great potlucks to invite our friends along. Amen.
当然这也是代表着我们将来也是会可以这样子做，在我们家里然后准备很多食物邀请朋友来。
Then our friends from our neighborhood can come. You know, sometimes they don't want to come here because, wow, a little bit long distance.
那有时候邀请他们来到这边来可能比较远一点，但是去我们家比较容易，对不对？
So anyway, mom cooking noodles, and then mom saw Erica coming to the kitchen.
然后母亲在厨房煮面，然后之后看见Erica, 小 Erica, 走进来。
So mom was so excited, look at Erica and say, Erica, do you want to eat some, you want to eat me?
然后就跟她说，她说 Erica, 你想要吃一点面是吧？
Erica looked at mom in a very, you know, neutral face and said, mom, I don't want to eat you.
然后之后呢，这一个这个 Erica 呢，就一个非常无辜和非常无知的看着母亲说：“哎，我不想要吃你。
”Okay, I'm sure you have your own cute situation.
我知道你们大家都有一些经历，就是一种很特别跟我们小孩小的时候。
So, children, right? Lack knowledge. Their mind is, you know, empty. They are there to soak in more information.
他们就是在那边就是想要知道更多去学习脑子还是空空的。
Okay, and children are in a stage of very vulnerable.
然后呢，这个小孩呢，在这个阶段呢，是非常的容易受到伤害的。
Okay, and you know, little kids, everything is a toy.
对小孩来讲，你看见每样东西都是很好玩的。
The more you stop them from playing that toy, the more they want to play it.
你越拦阻他不要玩那个玩具，他越想玩。
Okay, and they love the toy on the wall, the electric socket.
特别是喜欢在墙上的那个电桌。
So they're very vulnerable. If you don't protect them, they're gonna get, you know, electrocuted, right?
所以呢，他们是那么容易受到伤害。如果我们不好好的保护他，他就会受到伤害，被电击了。
So what else? They're easily distracted. You know, they play this for a while, a few minutes, and then, oh, another new toy. Play that, or you go to the market, right? They are buying this thing, or you're buying that thing, and then all of a sudden something different, and then they run over there. Easily distracted.
而且呢，他们还有另外一个特征是很容易分心。刚刚好玩住这一样东西呢，一看见另外一个新的东西就赶快走过去了。
Okay, and they change their mood. Very easily. 1 minute, super happy. Next minute, the scream.
那当然还有另外一个，就是他情绪波动很大。他可以这分钟在笑，下一分钟就在哭闹了。
So those are characteristics of a little child. And now, similarly, spiritual infant have some of this characteristic, and some are also different.
当然就好像小孩这样属灵婴孩的阶段跟小孩这个阶段有很多相似也有很多不一样的地方。
Now, it is very important here because some of you might feel like, well, I'm no longer a spiritual infant.
当然我们当中有一些我们认为我们已经不是小孩了。
Okay, and you wonder, you know, how is this going to apply to me?
我们既然不是小孩怎样子应用在我身上。
So if you're not a spiritual infant and you feel like you're not in that particular stage, that's okay.
那如果你真的是认为你不真的不在那个阶段的话，是还好。
Because you need to learn to be what? A spiritual parent to guide and nurture our young ones in our church.
那你应该是可以从那个阶段去做一个属灵的，当一个属灵的父母去。帮助另外不成熟的婴孩。
Okay, so that's why it's important for you to understand this stage, so that you know when there's a friend that comes to church and want to study the Bible, or there's a new baby Christian. Hey, we all need to help these people to grow up into spiritual maturity.
这是为什么我们呢？不管在什么时候，我们看见有属灵的婴孩在我们当中，我们都应该付出的去帮助和教导他们。
So that's why it's important to understand their characteristics.
所以呢，我们真的需要了解到这个特征是什么。
Or the other thing is maybe certain areas in your life you're still in a spiritual infant.
也或者你发现你生命的某一个部分是在这个婴孩，这是属灵婴孩的阶段。
Okay, and for those of us, if you identify with this stage, then this is a stage where you need toKnow yourself so that you can grow to be a spiritual parent.
那你如果是发现你自己在这个阶段的话呢，你就应该努力的去建立成长，而成为一个属灵的，可以当一个属灵的父母。
So first area, all right? As a baby Christian, spiritual infant, you know, our minds, okay, we lack knowledge about God, the Bible, the Christian walk.
那么属灵的婴孩也就是年幼的基督徒的意思，那么他第一个特征是他比较缺乏知识。
And we don't understand why we practice certain practices.
也就是说我们有时候真的不是很了解我们为什么要做我们要做的事情。
Okay, the challenge comes is this, because we are no longer physically infant.
因为我们这样想的原因是我们觉得我们自己肉体上 已经是一个年啊啊一个一个成年人了。
So we have a lot of experiences growing up in this world.
那我们在这个世界上也学习了不少的经验。
So when you come and join the kingdom of God, all of a sudden you find, oh, this experience is different from what I experienced here.
那你却发现说，你成为基督徒过后，哎，我的属灵生命和我以前所累积的经验，哎，不一样哦。
You know, and one of the characteristics which I'll put later on is then you get a sense of conflict and confusion.
然后之后呢，你就拥有一种感觉，你觉得好像很多的矛盾，很多的冲突，很多的混淆。
But it's important for us, okay, to learn to let go of all the old experiences that might not be helpful.
但是呢，其实我们需要做的是放弃那一些不健康、以前不好的这些习惯
，and be willing to learn again，
然后重新的再去学习啊、一个新的生命
，learn how to study the Bible，
比如说啊、去学习读圣经
，learn how to pray，
学习祷告
，learn how to fellowship，
学习怎样子去跟彼此交流
，yeah， fellowship is a skill，
其实跟彼此交流。就是一种、就是需要学习的技巧
Learn how to be warm as a person
也或者是学习怎样子能够很热忱的对人
Okay, so a lot of things to learn
很多东西需要学习
Alright, next one, as a young Christian Young Christians are in a vulnerable stage
那当然、年幼的基督徒也就是属灵的婴孩呢是也很容易受到伤害。
Later, I'll read to you a scripture about this particular area of vulnerability.
嗯，我们将会用一节经文来形容它。
And young Christian, younger Christian, easily distracted, isn't it?
也或者是年幼的基督徒呢，也比较容易分心。
Because our heart, you know, we want to learn about God. You know, God is so this new thing. You know, God is so exciting, but the world seems to be exciting too.
因为你有一种挣扎是属灵生命关于到神也有很多东西可以学习，但是同的时候在世界上有很多的吸引你的事情。
And you find that your mind, your eyes, you're always turning, you know, looking here. Oh yes, I'm gonna learn about God. But my friends are doing this, you know. Oh wow, God is so awesome.He got a new handphone. You know, you're easily distracted by the world.
是的，你就那种感觉，就是你在一边，你在觉得哇，神是那么的特别的，那么多东西可以学。可是哦，在一转现看另外一面的时候，你的朋友哇，完了也是很有趣的东西哦，你就抓不稳立场。
Okay, spiritual adult also feel that way, right? By the way,
成熟的。的基督徒们也相同面对这个问题，对不对
？But you know, it's important to recognize that because we need to learn to practice discipline, okay, self-control. Obviously, you know, God gives us things of the world and joy, but it's important to be committed to your God.
当然，今天重要的是我们要知道他这种挑战的存在，而我们去学习如何去面对和学习怎样子自律的去避免。
And of course, we talk about the confusion, right? Okay, because you have old experiences, whether it's from, you know, being religious, or maybe you are from another Christian faith, or maybe you are totally a free thinker. There's so many experiences that you have, you bring in, and there's conflict in your mind.
也或者是刚才我们谈到关于到有很多的混乱，是不是？那混乱是来自什么地方呢？来自可能你来自不同的宗教背景啦，你来自不同的。基督教的教导的背景啦，甚至你来自很多不同的想法，然后你觉得这东西掺在一起的时候，你觉得自己有一点混乱。
And then you have many friends who will come to you and even offer other ways to quote unquote have a good life or have faith, and then you get confused.
也或者是你、有一些朋友呢跟你分享，哇，另外一种方法，新的方法。可以让你过的生命不一样，好的又有信心的哦，然后你就开始乱了。
I can remember when I was in the university. Okay, if you're in college, every college students are the most opinionated people in the world.
啊，是的，就比如说我还记得我自己在大学的时候，然后大学有个特征就是说，这些人在周围的全部都是哇，他们非常的主观性很强的人。
And even if they are not sure what they learn, you know, they don't learn only a little bit, but they talk like, hey, I'm the authority.
嗯，就算他们在大学里面，他们还在学哦，他们也讲到自己好像是哇，就是充满知识，然后他就是权威这样子。
And when I was in college, I had so many debates and arguments with other college students about different faith and different religion and different forms of Christianity. Why, my goodness, it bombards me all the time.
那我还记得我在大学的时候，然后跟别人啊讨论啊，跟别人就是有这个辩论会关于到什么信心啊，什么怎样子的信仰啊等等，哇，就是一直在做。
And I even remember one of my friends from Iraq, yeah, and he's from a different faith, and he come and he put say, hey, Taekmin, you don't just have to believe in one God. I mean, hey, my God, better accept every way.Okay, isn't that better? Peace, united, unity. It accepts everyone. Isn't that a better faith? And then after a while, I was like, yeah, sounds very good. Sounds very reasonable.
然后之后我还记得有一个朋友，他是来自伊拉克的。然后他就跟我分享，他讲说 ，Dickman， 你并不知道，你看我的宗教不错嘞，我宗教是全世界的都接受的，然后我们也带给大家都是平安的。你看，我听了过后，我觉得也不错，其实。
And then other friends will come and say, Tech, don't be so committed. Why are you so committed to your God? Why do you have to go to church on Sunday and then go to Friday night, the devotional, and teach people the Bible? Why are you so committed? Is your God going to give you money from the sky?
然后呢还有另外一个朋友，他就跟我这样讲了 Tech.啊、你这么这样投入，每个礼拜天要去教会，你的神在天上给你钱吗？不用这样投入的。
Okay, I'm sure you yourself have faced this kind of challenges.、
我相信大家都可能面对过类似的这种挑战。
Okay, and there are some, USA, a lot of people with different faith. They would challenge me, right? And say,Are you sure you really need to be baptized to be saved?
然后之后在美国的时候呢，就有很多不同的这种信仰的人，他就会问我说，那 Dickman， 那你真的认为就是要受洗哦才可以得救吗？真的吗？
All you have to do is believe, and you don't even really have to focus on how you live your life. God is so loving.
你知道吗？神哦，是那么的充满爱心的。你只要接受他，相信他就够了。就算生命没有很大改变 ，OK。
Okay, so many conflicts, confusion, and I sometimes wonder what is the right way.
然后呢，其实啊，今天再想回来，就是这么多的混乱呢、啊，我在想说哪一个是对的，我自己也在搞得一塌糊涂。
And that's why the book of Ephesians chapter 4 talks about it. Let's read verse 14, Ephesians chapter 4.
好，让我们来看以弗所书第四章第十四节，这里说，使我们不再做小孩子，中了人的诡计和骗人的手段，给异教之风摇撼，飘来飘去。
Infant, spiritual infant.Toss back and forth, lack stability, lack knowledge, right? That's what the Bible says. Paul warned the church, please make sure you take care of the spiritual infants.
就好像保罗在这边，他其实在警告这些基督徒，他说，当我们是属灵婴孩的时候，我们很容易受到别人欺骗，我们很容易就是中了别人的诡计而变得混乱了。
So, what do you do when you're confused?
当你混乱的时候怎么办
？Okay, where do you go?
你去哪里？你要怎么做
？Our favorite friend, Google.
你会去找你最好、最要好的朋友谷歌大哥吗
？Google 大哥 ，right? We tend to, when we're confused, always go to Google.
然后之后你一觉得自己混乱了你就是去找这位大哥了
，right? Or the other good friend, YouTube.
也或者是另外一个好朋友，YouTube.
I mean, those things are good and they give us information.
是的，这些是很好的平台，可以给我们很多的知识。
But the most important is our standard, the Word of God. The Bible never changes. When you're confused, go dig deep in the Bible and see what the Bible really teach.
其实，我们应该要回到去那个永远不会改变的圣经那一本书。
Okay, and when we go back to the Word of God, obviously with guidance from spiritual, mature people, then your faith will be concrete.
因为当我们重新回到圣经，加上那些成熟，就是基督徒能够帮助你的时候，你的生命，你的信心就会改变和成长。
And that's what helped me when I was in the university.
那就是在我大学的时候，我觉得我如何受到帮助。
You know, with all these people, when I was confused, I decided I'm going to write small research paper to debate with them using the Word of God.
那我还记得我在大学的时候，我就做了这样的决定，去做一些研究，然后就跟他们就是根据圣经的角度来跟这些人做辩论，然后我觉得这个帮助我不少。
So I search into the Bible dictionary, Bible concordance, and go into the Word of God and research in the topic. Is Jesus the only way?
然后呢，比如说我对耶稣是唯一道路的这一个课题上，引用了很多的圣经工具来去做了这个研究，来才去跟这些人讨论。
Okay, does God wants me to be 100% towards Him?
是的，我也比如说去回答神是不是真的需要我要求我 100% 的去归向他呢？
Does the Bible really talks about heaven and hell? Is this real or is this a figment of my imagination?
也是另外一个问题，天堂和地狱是真的吗？我们需要很认真的对待它吗？是圣经这样讲吗？我们需要去做研究。
Okay, so brothers and sisters, you're confused. Go back to the Word of God. That's the standard that never changed. Do your own research. Obviously, you can get some guidance from different people. And also, yes, Google can guide you too.
当然了，今天弟兄姐妹，如果你是觉得在这地方有混乱，而且不清楚的话呢，那么你应该做的是去寻求圣经上的帮助，然后当然也可以在谷歌上找一些资料了。
So,If you feel like you are in this stage, okay, spiritual infant, what do you need?
如果你发现你自己的确是在这个属灵的婴孩阶段里，那你该怎么做？
Okay, and if you feel like you're not in this stage, a mature adult, spiritual mature, then what do you need to learn to help spiritual infant?
当然，如果你发现你自己已经成为了一个属灵的父母的话，那你应该要学习些什么来去帮助人呢？
We all need guidance to spiritual truth and the new life.
那我们每一个人都需要引导去成长。
You know, I appreciate when I was a young Christian, this particular brother in America, you know, sometimes a bit annoying, but you know, thinking back, I really appreciate him. Bruce Charlemagne, you know, you don't know him, okay?
Yeah, 我提到这样子有这种特征的人，我想到在美国的一位弟兄叫做什么
Bruce Charlemagne. Okay, all right. So you know, I really appreciate we live in the same dormitory, same hostel, and every day he'll come to my room and he say, "Hey, Tech Ming, let's pray together."
那么这位弟兄呢，他就是因为我们都住在同一个宿舍里，所以每一天哦，他都会来找我。他 Tech Ming， 哎，我们可以一起祷告吗
？Okay, Tech Ming, do you have any question I can help you with？
然后他每次他都会问我说，你有没有什么疑问我可以帮忙的
？You know, Tech Ming, let's set some goals of what to do. Where do you want to grow in as a as a Christian this year？
他会问我说，你觉得你今年你的成长目标、成长方向是什么？
Okay, of course, he kind of overdid it, so I felt annoyed with him.
当然，他做的有一点点过火了，然后我觉得有一点点烦了。
Okay, every morning, every afternoon, every evening. Okay, please.
他会每天早上、下午、晚上都不停的轰炸我。
But I do appreciate his persistency, and because of that, I grew as a Christian.
但是我今天很感激他的那个态度，就是他坚持他的立场，所以我才可以成长。
So, young Christian, if you're in this stage, go get help.
那年幼的基督徒，如果今天你在这个阶段里呢，你应该要去寻求帮助，而且去成长。
An older Christian, be that help. Find that one person that you're going to focus on to help grow in the faith.
年长的基督徒呢，你也需要去成长，去学习如何帮助另外一名年幼的基督徒一起的去成长。
Okay, second area, develop new spiritual habits.
那么第二点就是去培养属灵的新习惯。
Habits like reading your Bible every day.
比如说每天读圣经的习惯。
Pray every day.
每天祷告的习惯。
Come to church every week.
或是每个礼拜都来参加聚会。
Okay, it's a habit. It's something that you have to do again and again until it becomes automatic.
那你必须要一直这样子不断培养自己，直到自己可以培养这个属灵的好习惯。
Habit like learning to love the people around you, the brothers and sisters around you.
或者是培养那一些你会爱别人的一种好习惯，比如说周围的人，你都可以学习如何去爱戴他们。
That means you have to. Yes, sacrifice.
是的，这表示说你需要学习如何牺牲。
You know, your time, your effort, you have to sacrifice.
你的时间，你的精神你要付出的。
Right, our lives before we become a Christian, it's all about who? Me, myself, and I. Your whole world is about you.
在还没成为基督徒之前呢，你的世界是什么呢？就是你自己，你的世界，你自己罢了。
Okay, but Jesus is always about people.
可是呢，耶稣基督呢，是他的生命一切都是关于到在乎别人。
You read the Bible early morning. He tries to go out to pray, and then the people come.
天很早的时候呢，当耶稣想要尝试去祷告，那些人都已经开始找他了。
Okay, and then he teach. After that, okay, let's retreat to somewhere to rest, and then people come.
比如说他很累了，想要找个地方休息。哦，那边那些人都还在等他。
Okay, and then of course you know, in the evening, you know, want to have dinner, and then people come.
晚上要吃晚餐，饿了，然后人还在，还有。
Okay, and then what? Time to sleep. What does Jesus do? Sometimes he'll go off to pray for the people around him.
也或者是晚上疲倦了，想要休息睡觉。他还需要看见有人找他来为他们祷告。
So this is an area. All of us as Christian, okay, need to really learn to develop, into a spiritual habit.
那这一些刚才提到的，都是我们成为基督徒需要训练而成为习惯的一种生活方式。
And young people, spiritual infant, we all need attention.
当一名年幼的基督徒我们需要找到得到帮助而去成长。
Okay, and we need stability, right? Children need stability, stability and spiritual protection, just as what we read in the book of Ephesians.
那么当一名就是属灵的婴孩的就好像婴孩这样子需要能够有比较比较稳定，是比较稳定和属灵的保护。
That's why you need the gang, you need the church fellowship, you need the discipleship group that's going to strengthen you.
所以呢，我们需要什么呢？我们需要我们的小组里面的人来帮助我们。
Okay, you know, I appreciate all of us started the come, you know, in person, and of course, if you really cannot come, you know, be in Zoom, right? But why do we need to meet each other in church?
那我知道我们开始已经在回来教会但是我们也需要了解我们为什么需要聚在一起。
Okay, why don't we all just stay at home and switch on the TV and, you know, there you go, Taekming preaching, I can see him.
当然了，我们为什么不可以坐在家里，然后之后打开电视，打开这个电脑，Taekming 就在那边传道了吗 ？OK 啊
，OK， you know television evangelist， all right， I don't know， there's no such concept in Malaysia 。
touch the TV screen.
Yeah, touch the TV screen. Jesus, thank me and pray with me. We touch the TV screen together.
他传那个力量，就是就是电视上的传道人，然后美国很流行的，然后说你可以手就摸住那个电视镜，然后那他们的力量就传给你们了。
no matter how burdensome it is, we need one another. That's why you know group meetings, discipleship. You need the brothers, the sisters. We all need. We are social people. You cannot be alone.
那我们呢其实都需要彼此的，我们需要彼此的交流，彼此彼此的友情等等。
Okay, so let's be committed to our D groups and fellowship.
所以呢我们呢大家一起来做这个决定，能够很投入的能够参与。
So what is the key? Most important key, okay, to really grow as a spiritual infant.
那么这一个重点在于成长的重点是在哪里呢？
Right at the beginning, Jesus talks about the key to enter heaven. Matthew chapter 5, verse 3. Let's read that.
那一个锁匙，进入天国的锁匙，在马太福音第五章第三节。心灵贫乏的人有福了，因为天国是他们的。
Poor in spirit. And we know that means humility, being humble.
那么耶稣这里说，他说心灵贫乏就是等于是一个谦卑的人。
An eagerness to learn.
那一个拥有就是渴慕学习的态度和心。
When you think about it, why might we or any of us struggle with humility?
你知道为什么我们会挣扎谦卑而且挣扎在我们骄傲里面吗？
Okay, these are some reasons that I'm going to list down. I'm sure there are more.
我为大家列了这一些，当然有很多的，但是这是其中的几项。
Especially in our current age, you know, there's a spirit that is going on in the world. Yeah, you see in Hollywood, you see in the world, there's a glorification of the rabble spirit, the arrogant spirit, the me, myself spirit, that I'm strong enough, I'm a superhero spirit.
这一个呢其实 是世界的倾向就是全世界人 都在说就是主张自我主张着就是一种有一点傲慢和叛逆的那种想法。
Right? One man, you know, can battle.10 people, 100 people, no problem. Yeah, man, is it? Come.
然后就很像每个人都主张说，哎，你一个人，你就可以做到很多东西了。
Okay, I was talking to a friend just a few weeks ago, and you know, he says, if you see two people coming to you, or even three, you know, two or three people, don't think you're Ip Man or you're black belt. Run! Even your black belt, run.I appreciate what my friend said.
我还有一个朋友，他这样子来劝告我说，他说如果是真的，你就算是有黑带啊，那你看见三个人走来，你最好要走的是，要做的是跑啊。
You know, the rabble spirit, isn't it? They always show the hero that rescue everybody tend to be the rabble, isn't it? Tend to be the one that don't want to obey anyone.
那一些就是你看见就是每次不愿意去听从的都是那一些叛逆的。
You see that, brothers and sisters, there's a difference between courage and rebellious.
当然我们今天需要分辨什么叫做勇气，什么叫做叛逆。
Okay, we need to be courageous. It is the courageous people that win the war.
而我们需要知道的是那一些有勇气的人，他们可以战胜，而不是傲慢的人战胜。
Not the rebel.
Yep.
Okay, not the rebel. Right? King David, was he a rebel? No, he was courageous, but he was so submissive to God.
就比如说大卫王，大卫王他叛逆吗？并不是，他是很有勇气的一个王。
Okay, another reason why we might struggle is our physical age. You come in the kingdom, you know, maybe you are 20 years old or 30 years old or 40 years old. your physical age or your position in life, then you feel like I've experienced a lot, so I know a lot. Why are you teaching me?
另外一个就是我们的年龄层我们的年龄，比如说我们成为基督徒的时候，我们是年幼的，我们是年长的，我们是不同阶段的人。我们来了，我们有经验没有经验都好，都影响了我们的就是很难，就是在有这个骄傲的挣扎。
Okay, the danger of this, right? When you look at, you know, your own physical age or your position, is you sometimes you're not aware that spiritually you're still a baby.
因为很多时候呢，我们我们并不清楚，我们在属灵生命，我们还是一个小孩。
Another area is we are afraid, you know, to really be.Open, vulnerable, transparent. We are afraid of discipling and other people mentoring us because we are afraid that people will see our weaknesses.
而另外一样是我们害怕别人看见我们自己的软弱，然后我们不敢跟别人讲，然后这些事情呢拦阻了我们真正的可以得到帮助。
Okay, that's why Christianity is good news.It is okay for you to be weak, because we are all weak.
而在这一个方面呢，基督教呢其实是一个好消息的，因为基督教就是接受我们都是一个软弱的人，因为我们每一个人都有软弱。
But we must strengthen what is weak to be strong. Amen.
但是重要的是，我们必须要把我们软弱的能够改变成为刚强。
And then the other area is we have a wrong concept of humility.
当然，另外一个是你可能对于这个谦卑的概念有错误的想法。
Okay, here's another one. Our past hurts and scars, whether in our family or even in churches.
也或者是在当中还有另外一种，就是我们过去的这个伤痕，然后可能是在家里，也或者在教会。
Again, because, you know, maybe we were given advice and someone taught us in the past and then mistake happened and then you were hurt. And so now you're afraid to let people teach you again.
那可能是你的经历是以前你经历过可能有人教你在属灵上但是伤害你了。但是你这时候呢你就很难去放下而去就是你还坚持着这种挣扎。
Okay, and then I wrote one more. We are too self-reliant.
你或者是另外一个，再讲多一个，就是你太依赖自己。
All right, these are some challenges. If you find yourself in, you know, we call identify with one of these challenges, talk about it, get help, pray to God about it, so that you can learn to overcome and grow into a spiritual adult.
那如果今天你发现你自己有这类似这种挣扎的话呢，你需要做的是你向神祈求祷告，让神可以改变你，可以帮助你。
Okay, because there is a big danger when we're not humble.
因为呢，如果我们不可以，而且挣扎着谦卑的话呢，是很危险的。
And you know what's a big danger?
那为什么危险
？Jesus teaches us here in Matthew chapter 13 verse 19.
他在马太福音第十三章十九节，耶稣说：“他说，凡是听了天国的道却不明白的，那二者，就来把撒在他心中的夺去，这就是撒在路旁的。”
Okay, this is the parable of the sower. The Bible says what? When we hear the word, but we don't take it in, we're not humble. The bird come, pew.Very fast. I'm sure it has happened to you before. You go on a picnic, you close your eyes, and all of a sudden, some, you know, some magpie and crow all over your food. It's like, oh, what happened?
是的，就很像圣经上耶稣他这边他警告了我们，他说，如果我们听了神的话而没有去跟从的话呢，就很像很像天上的鸟这样子，突然间看见地上有食物，然后突然间很快的就把它给把你食物给偷走了，偷吃掉了。
Okay, so don't let the devil steal the word of God from you.
所以呢，今天呢，不好让 那恶者就是魔鬼把你心中的那个种子、神的那个信心的种子而给偷走掉。
Okay, and finally, spiritual adults, if you find yourself, I'm not in that infant stage. Well, this is a verse for all of us.
那你如果是觉得说今天你并不是一个属灵婴孩，而是你觉得你已经成长的话呢，这节经文是给你们看的。在箴言第22章第6节，教养孩童走他当行的路，就是到老他也不会偏离。
So obviously this applies to both family life, and also it applies to our church.
当然这在你不管是在你的家里还是在属灵生命，其实都可以拿出来去使用。
So in family life, again brothers and sisters, it isWhose responsibility to help your children to be godly?
那如果是在家里的话呢，是谁的责任去帮这些小孩去成长呢？
Okay, it is not the responsibility of the children ministry.
那绝对并不是在教会上帮你们孩子带领你们孩子的那些老师。
It is us as parents that we need to be the one to take charge.
而是我们呢，当名父母，我们需要负起这一个教导孩子的那个责任。
Now, of course, Kids Kingdom, Children Ministry, Lee and Eric, Sean, Angie, whoever who is in the young people ministry, they are there to help you.
当然 Eric, Lee and Sean, Angie, 他们在可能还是谁都好，可以帮助。
But you as parents, we as parents need to be the one to make sure that they get the help.
但是呢，当名父母是我们的责任，我们需要就是一定要帮助我们的孩子，这是我们的责任去帮助他们。
And in the same way, in church, okay, so if you are not a spiritual infant, you are a spiritual adult, well, let's find that one person to teach the Bible to help them to become a Christian.
那如果是你在教会的话呢？那么你也应当去学习，去找那一个可能你可以帮助和可以就是教导的那个人。
Okay, or find that person in church or in your group that you're gonna pray together frequently throughout the week.
在你的小组，在你的教会里面呢，可能你可以找到那一个可以跟你一同去成长、帮助到他的那一个人，然后在这个礼拜里面去约一起祷告啊、读圣经等等。
You know, is it tiring? Yes, every parent will tell you it is tiring.
如果你问这些父母，他们这样做会很疲倦吗？那是当然的，作为每一个父母都会很疲倦的。
But the good news is, you know, 10 years later, you look back and you see, wow, that bro, you know, that brother, you know, wow, I spent so much money on him, buying him dinner. Kidding. Helping him to grow. And he's grown, and you feel...fulfilled.
特别是当你在帮助了一个弟兄，可能在几年后，可能你看见他的改变，你心中你会回想起来，你就说，哇，我的付出是那么的值得。
So in our church, okay, let's everyone make that decision today. I want to grow from infancy to maturity.
所以呢，在今天，我们需要每个人做这个决定，每个一定要。就是成长能够在属灵生命更加的成熟。
And all of us, okay, not just a small group or your leaders, all of us want to be involved in helping one another and helping our friends to really know God.
甚至呢，我们需要学习这个态度，就是不单单是领袖罢了，而是每一个人都需要成长。需要去付出帮彼此帮助让这个教会可以成长。
And why? Because this is our church, your church. So come follow me, we talk about spiritual infancy, we talk about characteristic of a spiritual infant. Humility is the key to growth, and there's a that we talk about the challenges and the danger of not being humble, and for us who are spiritual adult, go and teach.
那为什么我们需要这样做呢？理由很简单，这是我们的教会。然后呢，我们今天学习到四样东西，我们学到比如说属灵婴孩的这些特征，而且谦卑呢是在成长是一个 很重要的一个关键。然后呢，我们甚至看见到比如说我们不谦卑的时候会很危险的。所以到最后呢，我们也需要去大家做这个决定，一起成为这个属灵成长的这个人。
Amen. So now we're going to be having communion and Chun Xian will pray for us.
So 我们将会由俊贤来为我们祷告关于到这个这个圣餐的这个祷告。
弟兄姐妹，此刻让我们低头为这个饼跟酒祷告。亲爱的天父，感谢你父，今天呢我们能够再一次的在这边去领受这圣餐的父，我感谢你今天的传道跟这个信息所带来，让我们知道说让我们能够去谦卑的去学习，让我们能够去改变我们的生命，我们的生活方式，知道说我们要去成长，让我们能够去知道说关爱我们身边的人。你知道很多时候我们就是太自我中心，并且不知道怎样去关爱身边的人。然后知道说今天当我们去领受这圣餐的时候，知道说神啊，你是很大的牺牲，用你的生命去救赎我们的生命的父。感谢你今天呢，当我们领受拿着饼的时候，这饼代表着你的身体为我们的罪而受伤的。感谢你，也让我们知道说这拿着这杯的时候你的代表着你的宝血为这洗去我们的罪而流的。感谢你，这祷告是奉我主耶稣的名祷告所求的，阿们。
Amen. Thank you, Jun Xian. So brothers and sisters, let's the bread and wine, the cup will be passed around. Okay.When you hold, you get it, please hold it together. Okay, the music, let's play the music and take some time, take a moment to meditate on it. Okay, after around 2 minutes, something, we break the bread and take the cup together. All right, 歌可以先放了。弟兄姐妹朋友们，我们待会会一起拿着这个。hold 着这个杯，我们先不要用它在音乐当中我们可以一起去思想主耶稣对我们的爱，然后差不多两分钟过后我们一起打开这个饼跟酒一起用。 Amen.让我们一起打开这个饼跟酒。在这个哥林多前书这边说，当日主耶稣被卖的那一夜，他拿起饼来，祝谢了就擘开，说：“这是我的身体，为你们舍的，你们应当如此行，为的是纪念我。”让我们一起用。饭后也照样拿起这个杯来说：“这杯是用我的血立的新约，你们每逢喝的时候要如此行，为的是纪念我。”让我们一起用来纪念耶稣。
Okay, brothers and sisters, today we don't have any special announcement, but as per usual, Sunday service, next Sunday, as per usual, 3:30 here. And then midweek service also the same. Please come to the church, okay? We will never provide you any Zoom link, okay? Okay? Please come to the church, okay? Maybe even though maybe service statement not going to teach us, but we have D group, okay? All right? Okay, 弟兄姐妹，我们没有特别的报告。 不过我们的星期天聚会呢，照样是在这边3:30。然后我们的周间聚会呢，请大家记得大家来到教会这边，因为我们没有提供你们那个线上的聚那个网Zoom link， 我们没有提供，所以希望大家都能够回来这边。OK， 所以今天的报告到此，然后让我们大家一起站起来交流。OK，Thank you。